Union Minister Sadananda Gowda, who took a flight from Delhi to Bengaluru but didn't get quarantined, as it is the norm for every flyer from Delhi to Bengaluru to be quarantined. In fact, Sadananda Gowda left for his residence and not for an institutional quarantine. Speaking to India Today, the Union Minister claims that he is Pharma Minister and he is exempt from quarantine norms. But Karnataka government notification on quarantine exemption doesn't mention any pharma sector under exempted category here. Very shocking, to say the least. Union Minister Sadananda Gowda, who took a flight from Delhi to Bengaluru, landed in Bengaluru and went straight to his house, did not go through the mandatory institutional quarantine that the Karnataka government itself demands. The Karnataka government says 7-day institutional quarantine, 7-day home quarantine. Here is Sadananda Gowda. The moment he lands, he goes straight home. He doesn't go to an institutional quarantine. Speaking to India Today, the Union Minister claims that he's a pharma minister. And since he's a pharma minister, he's exempted from quarantine norms. But Karnataka government notification on quarantine does not exempt any pharma sector personnel, including the pharma minister, to be exempted from this category. In fact, all people landing into Karnataka will have to mandatory go through quarantine period. Here is Sadananda Gowda, who goes straight to his home, violating the norms that has been put in place by the Karnataka government itself. Let's go over to Nagarjun joining us some more on this. Nagarjun, please take us through. Sadananda Gowda, Minister for Pharma Minister there, walking straight out rules. Anybody coming in from Delhi or six of the hard-hit cities will have to go through quarantine period of 14 days, institutional quarantine for 7 days and then 7 days home quarantine. Why is Sadananda Gowda exempted?
That is absolutely true, Nabila. In fact, the minister from Delhi landed this morning around 11 o'clock to 11:30 is what we are told. He didn't even get into an ambulance or the BMTC bus, which are kept for passengers. Anyone who is landing from Delhi, as per the Karnataka government norms, that they have to undergo institutional quarantine for 7 days and 7 days later home quarantine. So 14 days, the minister will have to undergo quarantine in Bengaluru. But when I spoke to the minister, he says that he's a pharma minister and he's exempted from any quarantine norms. But the Karnataka government notification on exemptions for any quarantine facility doesn't mention anyone under pharma sector. It is only for persons who are 80 years and above, persons below 10 years, or any ailment like kidney failure, cancer patients. Only these are the exemptions that is available at this point of time. There's nothing specific on pharma industry or pharma minister. It's clear the VVIP culture is seen here, brazen violation of norms, even though Delhi is a red zone. That is the reason why Karnataka has made compulsory quarantine for anyone.
Right, Nagarjun, was he stranded in Delhi and has he gone back after 2 months, or what's it like?
He was in Delhi since 2 months because there was no flight since March 24th. Post the previous parliament session, he was there because he also had to officially work because he is pharmaceutical as well as chemical and fertilizer minister.
Right.
He says that he was doing video conference calls with South ministers, Southern ministers, including Karnataka. He's got a chance today, but even he landed, he has to undergo quarantine, which he has skipped. He also told me that he has a meeting with Karnataka Health Minister today and Kerala Health Minister.
So basically, if he's going home, he's not going to stay home. He's going to get out there, go for meetings and carry on with business like regular.
Absolutely, that's exactly even a bigger violation, because he's not even going to be at home, not home quarantine. Today he told me that he has a minister meeting in Karnataka. He's meeting the health minister. This is not the first time that VVIP culture is seen here. Remember the earlier times how cabinet ministers of Karnataka who were supposed to be in a quarantine didn't follow the norms. And today the central minister, an MP from Karnataka, is again breaking the law.
Absolutely shameful. Nagarjun, in fact, just a little while ago you had a word with Sadananda Gowda. Let's take a listen into his justification, what he has to say in his defense.
There's a lot of news that you came in from Delhi and not under institutional quarantine. The rules are that anyone who comes from Delhi should go under institutional quarantine, sir.
Sir, I am a pharma minister, sir.
Yes, sir.
It is my responsibility to tour across the country, and I should see that the sufficient production is there, sufficient supply is there. So, in the exemption class, it is clearly mentioned that any persons pertaining to pharma sector, they are allowed to move across the country.
Okay, sir. But how long is your trip going to be? So how long will you be in Bangalore, sir?
Sir, that I don't know. Today afternoon I am going to have a meeting with the health minister, Karnataka. Okay. Tomorrow I am planning to go to Kerala. There also I want to have a meeting with the health minister and the health secretary.
Okay.
So I'm in the southern parts of the country, because I could not come over here. There was no domestic flight so far.
Okay.
So I could not able to come over today. Domestic flight started. I had been to Himachal Pradesh. I had been to that areas in the, near in and around Delhi.
Okay.
So I don't know why.
So because a lot of people on Twitter and social media are questioning why the rules different for minister and common people.
Sir, there are few medias which doesn't have any other news. So they will make this news. I'm sorry to say this.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Well, let's quickly go back to Nagarjun for more on that. Nagarjun, he says the media has not got any other news to flash, which is why we are taking this up. Absolutely shameful, to say the least. He's clearly undeterred, absolutely no remorse to what has happened. He does not even, doesn't sound apologetic, to say the least. In fact, he says, I'm exempted, very confidently, when the Karnataka government guidelines itself very clearly mentions a 14-day quarantine period, 7 days institutional quarantine, 7 days home quarantine, and no exemption for anybody from the pharma sector, even be it the minister of the pharma sector here. And he, and the way he has spoken in his justification is clearly not convincing.
Well, that is absolutely true. It may be that he went to Himachal Pradesh or any other state in the northern part of India when he was there, but it depends on state to state. Maybe Himachal Pradesh doesn't require institutional quarantine for anyone coming from Delhi, but Karnataka specifically on paper has put in notification that anyone who's coming into Delhi via road, rail or air will have to undergo institutional quarantine for 7 days, and on the fifth day, they will have to give this swab test for COVID-19. Here is a union minister who is an MP from Karnataka, lands in Bengaluru from Delhi after 2 months, doesn't even undergo home quarantine, least forget institution, not even home quarantine. There's no seal on the hand.
Absolutely. And then he says that he's going to Kerala, he's going to meet the ministers, he's going to... Is he not going to be putting everyone's lives at risk? At the moment, this is... we do know the nature of the virus. Asymptomatic carriers could affect those who are more vulnerable. Even if he has no symptoms now, God forbid, eventually if he does develop, it's putting all of those people who come into his contact at risk, absolute risk. And he is the pharma minister. He should know for the least that this is unsafe.
Absolutely true. Even if he was exempted also as an individual, he'll have to take certain care, be in at least home quarantine for a few days because he's come from a red zone. Delhi is a hot spot for coronavirus, and Karnataka in the last few weeks has been having more than 100 cases every day, and now our minister is not undergoing institutional quarantine. So the state government also has to answer a lot as to why is there different norms for people coming in on the same flight who get into ambulances and BMTC buses and taken to hotel or hospital. Here is a minister where the police are waiting for him. He gets into his car and drives back home. And after that also, he goes to meet the health minister and other officials.
Right. Nagarjun, absolute VIP high-handedness in display here. Let's quickly take a quick listen again to what Sadananda Gowda said to you a little while ago in his defense. He says that media is jobless, more or less, has nothing else to report, which is why this is news. Unfortunately, does not realize the risks of it.
There's a lot of news that you came in from Delhi and not under institutional quarantine. The rules are that anyone who comes from Delhi should go under institutional quarantine, sir.
Sir, I am a pharma minister, sir.
Yes, sir.
It is my responsibility to tour across the country, and I should see that the production, sufficient production is there, sufficient supply is there. So, exemption, in the exemption class, it is clearly mentioned that any persons pertaining to pharma sector, they are allowed to move across the country.
Okay, sir. But how long is your trip going to be? So how long will you be in Bangalore, sir?
Sir, that I don't know. Today afternoon, I am going to have a meeting with the health minister, Karnataka.
Okay.
Tomorrow, I am planning to go to Kerala. There also, I want to have a meeting with the health minister and the health secretary.
Okay.
So, I'm in the southern parts of the country because I could not come over here. There was no domestic flight so far.
Okay.
So I could not able to come over today. Domestic flight started. I had been to Himachal Pradesh. I had been to that areas in the, near in and around Delhi.
Okay.
So I don't know why.
So because a lot of people on Twitter and social media are questioning that why is the rule different for a minister and common people?
Sir, there are few medias which doesn't have any other news, so they will make this news. I'm sorry to say this.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.